How was the process of adapting the miniseries?
Well, the miniseries was the entire Bible. And Son of God is the story of Jesus. And the movie takes you on a journey through the life of Jesus from his birth in our Christmas story, mm-hmm. right through his death, his resurrection and ascension, in through the Great Commission. So it's a beautiful 2-hour standalone cinematic experience. It's very powerful and very, very touching.
Mm-hmm. I think that one of the things I really like is that the values that we see, yeah, it's independent if the person is religious or not, because yeah, exactly. we see his, pacifism, social justice, etc., etc. How important is for you to promote those values that are universal?
I mean, first of all, for me as a viewer and as a person, as a human citizen, it is tremendous, and as a father as well. It is tremendous to have a chance of seeing something that actually means something. To the world, talking about stuff that it regardless of whatever you are or whatever you believe, you can relate to. You believe in, you struggle with the same things as 2,000 years ago. It's basically the same stuff. The age, the conditions has changed, but not that much. Mm-hmm. So it is really important, and I think it was a goal for all of us. I mean, producer side and acting side. To make it as most reachable and tangible possible, not forgetting obviously the Gospels and the story we were telling, but in a way that everybody can understand and be connected to.
Mm-hmm. I know that talking about the distribution of the movie, for you, reaching out to the Hispanic population is also very important and in a kind of unique way. Tell me a little bit about that.
Yes, we absolutely are thrilled that the movie's coming out in Spanish and English on the same day in movie theaters. It's a very important and growing Spanish-speaking population. And they shouldn't wait weeks later or months later for the Spanish version. We have put it out on the same day so that even though most Hispanic Americans can speak both languages, sometimes their grandparents and the parents only speak Spanish. Here's an opportunity as a whole family to go together and see Son of God on February 28th as a family in Spanish.
Fantastic. Last question. I really like the fact that the antagonists of the story, you kind of justify their point of view. It wasn't just they were evil all the time. There were some sociopolitical reasons for that decisions, right?
It's very like House of Cards, which is on Netflix, where you have the social turmoil of the time, political intrigue and drama, like a political thriller mm-hmm. with Pontius Pilate and Caiaphas and, of course, Jesus and disciples. But we showed that everybody had their reasons for what they were thinking, and it wasn't one-dimensional. And so it really gives you a new perspective on what was happening in AD 33.
Mm-hmm. Awesome. Thank you so much.